out. It's located next to the novelty booth behind the Turn 4 grandstand area. Bring your programs, get them signed, as you'll want to meet all your favorite SK Modified drivers in Autograph Alley here tonight. And that special guest that Jim interviewed earlier, Matt.
Yeah, and we are very happy to have with us Leanne Sikora, who is going to be our coordinator of Victory Lanes tonight, and signing autographs, Allie Rossi of the Southern Rain Band. And maybe she can belt out a few Miranda Lambert tunes for you when she's down there. Allie Rossi with our drivers, signing autographs tonight. And Allie, a very accomplished entertainer. Right now, the entertaining is going to be done by our Dare Stock drivers as the 62 aborted does not come up to speed, and Marcello Ruffrano does.
It is a mad scramble, and right in the middle of it all is Zach Robinson, gathers it back, forward motion. They are locked together momentarily. Everybody is spinning and sliding through the situation. Car number 29, it is Trace Meyer who is stuck in the inside of the infield, and it looks like we are going to
be under yellow, I think.
There it is. Caution flag comes out. Kind of a strange situation happening there because the field came back to the line.
It kind of sucked in everybody, including Zach Robinson, as he was being shoved around for about a half a lap. But everybody has settled down. The 62 aborted is on the safety road, so he will be in spectator country as we have this restart. Our point leader, well, we have a tie for the point lead. Two divisions tonight are tied heading in. Tyler Trott and Frank Lacroix Jr., the defending champion, are tied for the point lead. And Dan Dembeck is only 4 points back. Trace Meyer only 14 points off the lead. And we also have a tie in the SK Light standings between Joey Ferrito and DJ Burnham.
Well, they rumble back to the stripe. The green flag is out. And it is, oh, trouble. Down the front straightaway, we've got one around, Matt, backwards.
And a car pointed in the wrong direction. And that could be the 93 car of one of the guy that is contending for the points. Bring something that you would want to sell or whatever the case. I'll do a little bonding with Dad on his special day here at the Dave's Flea Market, and then on your way home you might want to go out and get something to eat. But what a great place to do some father and son quality time, or daughter and father quality time, than right here at Dave's Flea Market on Sunday.
And remember, the Gotham Dream Car Experience is coming up on Sunday, June 21st, here at the Speedway. It's an opportunity to go for rides in cars like Ferraris and Lamborghinis. So pretty awesome.
Right now, awesome is a word used to describe Alexandra Fern as she tries to rocket her way into the lead against Marcello Ruffrano.
She might have been, well, playing a little cat-and-mouse game in qualifying, because she now looks racy at the point. And Marcello continues to try to muscle his way to the bottom. But it's Alexandra Fern looking for back-to-back victories as she thunders down into turn number one. All of a sudden, another factor in this event becomes Zach Robinson. Now, Zach Robinson, we almost counted him out in the first lap, was his car became evil. Now he's up among the top four cars and reeling in on Lacroix for position number three.
And Zach Robinson had a pretty big night last night. He graduated from eighth grade. So one of the young competitors in our field trying to keep up with Frank Lacroix Jr. in car number 33. And leading the next crew, oh, trouble for Nicole Chambrello as she goes into the lawn off of the front straightaway.
See if she's able to fire it back up. Hopefully she will, and we can remain under green. But it doesn't look promising because there is the yellow as her car suddenly became evil off turn number four, and that's going to tighten it all back up with three laps of the 15 now into the record sponsor race car, Wheeler's Auto, and he continues to get stronger and stronger each and every time out. Lacroix is, of course, the defending champion and a contender tied in the points as the point contender for a second title here in the class, and then Zach Robinson won his first victory just a couple of weeks back. So there's a lot of talent that has been moving forward. Paul Verrecchio turning some heads tonight as well with that number 22 car. Let's see what's going to happen, Matt. Pace car pulls away from the field, and it looks like that Cam Robinson is going to give him the green, and he does. And Alexandra Fern continues to try to hold on to that number one spot, but Marcello is really giving him a run for the money.
Yeah, Marcello pretty smooth, so he is able to stay submitted to that number 12 car. As they swing off the corner, we have two drivers who are welded together. Alexandra Fern, Marcello Raffiano, and look at that number 33 of Latois trying to poke his nose into the party.
Certainly does. Robinson is right there and right to the front of the class again. Goes Dembeck. Marcello bounces off the wall. Frank Latois becomes a contender for the number one spot. They are side by side. The battle of the sexes.
Problem in turn one. Chambrello is around again. Also, a couple cars were in the grass. Alexandra Ford has been very smooth on these double file restarts the last couple of weeks. Hasn't been overdriving her car. Hasn't been spinning the tires. Let's see what she does against the defending champion.
Here they come. They're being told to cross over. Lights still remain on. It'll go off when they cross the start-finish line. And Latois trying to keep some heat in those tires as Alexandra Fern stays totally focused on her own line and her own situation. Marcello on the inside of the row with Robinson to the outside. That's row number two. Then it's Dembeck and the 22, and they're calling for the yellow instead of the green, so there must be a readjustment needed in the restart lineup to make sure that everybody's in the correct order. So a check with timing and scoring.
I think Marcello might be moving up in the second. At least that's the way our scoreboard is rating. So it looks like the 48 will be in second, and Frank Latois will be pushed back to third, and that is the adjustment that you were referring to.
So once we have that into play and those lights go off atop the pace car, we should be in good shape.
Marcello was pretty smooth on that last restart too. Remember a year ago at this time, Marcello was competing on Monday nights in the Wild Thing carts. So he has come a long way in a short period of time. And we are just about ready for a restart. One more time around under dress rehearsal conditions. Dembeck is fifth. Trace Beyer is seventh. And it seems this year you can't count out Dembeck, Beyer, and Trott. They always seem to be around on lap number 15.
You're right, Matt. They seem to just have enough to be there in the closing laps of the events for this season.
Doug Phelps out of the race in car number 21.
So, it looks like we're settling back in to go green. And there is the green. And Alexandra Fern and Marcello are evenly matched side by side into turn number two, almost glued together, Matt, as they head down the back straightaway.
Boy, this is a classic restart. They are still welded together as they enter the fourth turn. Maybe a slight advantage for Fern on the inside. They shuffle off the corner, and your leader is going to be, I think, Alexandra Fern, but not by much.
Well, if it was, it was so tiny. Let's see what's going to happen as Alexandra stays focused at the point. Marcello.
And we have it in the yellow. It comes out.
And don't forget the Intrepid Fallen Heroes on Track Walk, presented by Napa and the Stafford Motor Speedway on Friday, July 17th. Now that's right. It's going to be taking place race night. All in attendance are invited to go trackside and take a walk on the famed half mile or the Legends mini mile. Fans, and get a different perspective of the oval from track side. Right now, we're getting a whole different perspective as the field is back through green and Alexandra Fern showing it was no fluke a week ago that she won because she's leading him down the back straightaway.
And she was able to pull away from the combination of Refrano and Latoya. Latoya making a desperate move. Maybe he is being shoved by the 93 at Denbeck. So they swirl around the corner, and Alexandra Fern is back in business.
No question about it. And Latoya currently sets in the second spot. Marcello still digging in hard on the outside, but here comes Denbeck. And Tyler Trott is in trouble, Matt. He spins underneath the Dunleavy's truck and repair sign, but gets it fired back up. And I think we're going to remain under green, and it looks like we are. Half of the event is all but history, and Alexandra Fern looks for back-to-back victories if she can hold on for the remaining eight laps of competition here.
And one of the roughest outings of the season for Tyler Trott. Now getting caught on the outside is Marcello Refrano, and he loses a spot to Denbeck in car number 93. Denbeck is getting a little pestering action to the back bumper of the Frank Latoya car. Best battle, second and third between Latoya and Denbeck. And then it's side-by-side between Robinson and Refrano.
Robinson tries everything. Refrano is on the outside. Tyler Trott, a lapped automobile. And here comes Zach Robinson up to the fourth spot, forcing Marcello to have to settle back in for five. But that's not over with yet. They're side-by-side as they rumble off turn number four. But Zach Robinson will pick up position number four. And what about the 29, Trace Meyer? Well, he was involved in a skirmish earlier, and he's now among the top six cars.
And he is looking to get by the 48 of Marcello Refrano, and that might not be easy to do. The drum major of the parade is Alexandra Fern, looking to go back-to-back. Five laps to go when they hit the one, and we know what a finisher that Frank Latoya is, and the same can be said for Dan Denbeck. Most of their wins have been come from behind specialties in the last few laps, so Alexandra Fern will have her hands full.
It is Denbeck who's the quickest car on the racetrack, and he now moves to the inside of Latoya. Side-by-side racing for second. Latoya drifts up the hill, loses a little ground, and Denbeck will now move into second. Alexandra Fern becomes the next target of Denbeck, and look at Zach Robinson. All of a sudden, he gets his second win, and Zach Robinson is now side-by-side with Latoya for that third spot.
As he's able to whirlwind his way underneath that number 33 car, Latoya, let's see what happens as they rampage their way off the corner. Latoya is holding on to third, but right now, two cars have pulled away slightly. The 12 of Fern, the 93 of Denbeck. Also in the vicinity is Frank Latoya. We are going to have a barn burner over the final 2.5 laps.
No question, they head down to turn number 3. Alexandra Fern looking for back-to-back victories. Lapped automobile up ahead. Passing flag is out. The number 84 could be in the direct line of fire. They head to the bottom of turn 1. Denbeck glued to the back bumper. Alexandra Fern still holds on. Off turn 2, it's still Fern down the back straightaway.
Alexandra Fern will try to keep her car down low. She knows Denbeck is capable of making a major move on the final lap. Fern will lead him into the corner. White flag is out. One more time around for Alexandra Fern, but here comes Denbeck.
Denbeck came from a spin early in the event. Alexandra Fern keeps digging in on the outside. They're wheel-to-wheel and side-by-side. Down the back straightaway, evenly matched. They head into turn number 3.
Any one of three cars could win it. Denbeck on the inside, surrounded by the 12 of Fern. Coming off turn number 4, here comes Denbeck. Here comes Fern, and Alexandra Fern has pulled it out.
Alexandra Fern takes it by inches, and the girl is on top of her game with back-to-back wins, and the fans really love it. In the runner-up spot, and Frank Latoya will finish among the top 3. That is the point battle this season, Denbeck and Latoya. And I think we're going to see a lot of great racing out of those two.
Yeah, Frank Latoya will take over the point lead, and Denbeck pulls to within 2 of Frank Latoya. That is unofficial. But what a helter-skelter move by Alexandra Fern. I thought maybe she was going too far to the outside, but she knew what she was doing. She had a rough heat race, but it shows it doesn't matter until the feature starts. And Alexandra Fern definitely had the fastest car tonight.
You know, interestingly enough, think about it. Tommy Fern won his third feature last week in the late models. And now Alexandra has two in a row in the Dare Stock division. That's pretty impressive all by itself.
And now we'll hear from our winner. His winner is Darren Ayotte.
The Ferns off the list now. To win back-to-back races this year, Alex, first of all, congratulations. But take me through those closing laps with a 93 car, Dan Denbeck, closing in. What was going on in your mind?
I knew that he was a fast car today, so I worried a little bit. But he really did make it exciting by making that move to the inside. I thought that was pretty cool. It's really fun to race against him, and I like being on the outside. So that was really awesome to win it on the outside. I'm excited about that.
Yeah, you said that for sure. You had some great restarts, though. You're able to hold your own. Take me through some of those restarts and how tough it is to stay, to hold that outside lane.
It is kind of tough. I mean, I just do what I'm supposed to do and hope that everything works out. And I guess it did again today. So happy birthday to Trace Byer's mom, Mrs. Byer. She's really awesome. She makes great food. My mom, they do so much for me, and it's Father's Day on Sunday, so I can't wish my dad a happier Father's Day. And I also can't thank Safeco Foam, Rad Auto Machine for the big power, Independent Racing Wheels, Stafford Motor Speedway, Napa Auto Parts, and Sunoco Race Fuels. So thank you.
Don't count Alex Fern out of the points race now. Closing in fifth place was now sent it to John Gates, who has second and third.
I got Dan Denbeck with me. Dan, oh man. Dan, I'll tell you what, man, that was tough right in the beginning there. The car spun out. You came back through the pack, and you almost had this win tonight.
Yeah, I almost had this win. I got taken out in a couple laps. I was just trying to drive it through the field. I just want to thank all the guys that work on this car, Jimmy, his son, my dad, my mom, my girlfriend, and the guys from Renner Race Car. This car wouldn't be on the track if it wasn't for them. Paint. Lucky's Riding Custom, and that's about it.
There he is, Dan Denbeck, second place tonight in the Dare Stock feature. Let's talk to Frank Latois, Jr. Frank, man, the 33 was rocking tonight. You just about got a top two there anyways, and looking good, though.
Yeah, we certainly didn't need all those cautions, but my team's doing a fantastic job keeping this car on the podium every night. Minuteman Press, Zeke's Pump Service, Wild Thing Karts, K&W, there's so many people. But I just got to thank my team, really, because they're keeping me in this, and it's fun to drive, it's fun to race with these guys, and can't wait to get back next week.
There he is, third place, Dare Stock feature, Frank Latois, Jr., in that number 33 car, and we're going to go back to the tower after a great Dare Stock main event.
Thank you very much, John. Coming up next is our limited late models, and...